So in the last lecture, we derived the conservation of mass equation. For a fluid in a porous media with porosity phi. And that's for a fully three-dimensional form. So the unknowns in this, of course, are the density, the velocity, and possibly the porosity as well. These could be spatially varying and varying in time. So we're going to make some assumptions in what follows to simplify this somewhat so that we can solve it for flow for a single-phase fluid with some constant properties in a reservoir. And so the first thing we'll do is we'll use Darcy's law, which you should be familiar with by this point in your petroleum engineering curriculum. Sorry, that's 1856, I believe. And Darcy's law says that, you know, the Darcy flux, Q, is equal to minus some permeability tensor over the viscosity times the pressure gradient minus density over the gravity vector, times the gravity vector. And the Darcy velocity is the volume per unit time flowing through cross section. So to get the actual velocity of the fluid in the pores, we have to divide the Darcy velocity by the porosity. So the actual velocity of the fluid flowing through the pores is the Darcy velocity divided by the porosity. Okay, so of course, if you write everything out, then that is. And of course, this is the three-dimensional case, so the permeability is a tensor or a matrix. So the pressure gradient is a vector. This term involving the gravity is a vector. And so you have a vector times a second-order tensor or a matrix, then a 3x3 matrix, then you have a vector. So you have a velocity vector. And of course, just I guess to be explicit, you know, the components would be in our sort of Cartesian x1, x2, x3 frame coordinates, we'd have components like this. And the tensor is symmetric. So in this case, the K21 is equal to K12. And the K13 is equal to K31. So I'll write 13 here. 2, 3 here, and 3, 3 here. Or if you prefer the sort of engineering notation. This. If the permeability is isotropic, right, so if the medium is isotropic, that means there's no preferential planes of flow direction. So in that case, the permeability would be a constant, right? So the permeability tensor would be not necessarily a constant, but rather, because it could be a spatially varying function of x still, but rather than we'd write it like this, or in matrix form, you'd have something like this. And then, yeah, if it's homogeneous, which would mean it doesn't spatially vary, then it would be a constant. Okay.